Sushruta for Neet is now available on the Google Play Store. Try it out for free.
Hi everybody. Hearty welcome to Jnanamarga Biology Classes. I am Professor G.K. Bhatt, engaging the biology class now. In the last session, we have started the study of the cell, the unit of life. In today's class, we shall take up the study of prokaryotic cells. In the last class, we have seen who has discovered the live cell first, who has observed the cells under the microscope first, who has put forward the cell theory. We have also studied the contribution of Schleiden, the contribution of Schwann, and also Virchow. With that basic knowledge on the cell structure of plant cell and animal cell, in brief, we are going to study now the detailed account of prokaryotic cell to be followed by eukaryotic cells. The prokaryotic cells are represented by bacteria, blue-green algae, mycoplasma, and pleuropneumonia-like organisms, which is abbreviated as PPLO. All these are known to possess prokaryotic cells. Always ask a question in both board examination as well as in a NEET. Which are the examples for prokaryotic cells? 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, bacteria, blue-green algae, otherwise called cyanobacteria, mycoplasma, all these you have already learned or studied in my previous classes. In addition to this, we are adding one more example for the prokaryotic cells, that is PPLO. PPLO abbreviation stands for pleuropneumonia-like organisms. So here, you can see the prokaryotic cells. Exemplified by bacteria, blue-green algae. Now, prokaryotic cells are generally smaller and multiply more rapidly than the eukaryotic cells. These are all prokaryotic cells. What you have? And this is the eukaryotic cell, a typical eukaryotic cell. And one major difference is that prokaryotic cells are generally smaller than the eukaryotic cell. You can see the sizes here. The sizes vary among the prokaryotic cells. Look here, a typical eukaryotic cell with the 10 to 20 mu m size. And here, typical bacteria 1 to 2 mu m. PPLO, about 0.1 mu m. That means you will see that these prokaryotic cells are generally smaller than the eukaryotic cells. the four basic shapes of bacteria. You can see here, the bacteria are the prokaryotic cells. And we have just said that the prokaryotic cells may vary greatly in shape and size. Now let us look into the shapes that prevail amongst to bacteria. Look here. This is what the spherical bacteria called coccus, comma-shaped bacteria, vibrio, rod-like bacteria, bacillus, and spiral bacteria, spirillum. So these are all basic types of shapes that you come across, or basic shapes you come across, four basic shapes in bacteria. One is rod-like bacillus, spherical coccus, comma-shaped vibrio, and spirillum. You must know both, all these four different shapes of bacteria. The organization of the prokaryotic cell is fundamentally similar, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and functions. If you look into these prokaryotes, now we have seen the prokaryotes includes that of bacteria, blue-green algae or cyanobacteria, and you heard about this mycoplasma or PPLO, pleuropneumonia-like organisms. Fundamentally, all these have similar organization, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and functions. Let us now look into what all these fundamental organization or structure of the prokaryotic cell. All prokaryotes have a cell wall surrounding the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Remember, all prokaryotes, they have a cell wall outer to the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Inside the cell, you come across cytoplasm, the fluid-filled matrix. Filling the cell is the cytoplasm. What is most important amongst these prokaryotic cells is that there is no well-defined nucleus. This is the most important feature of prokaryotic cells. There is no well-defined nucleus, or there is no membrane-bound nucleus. You know what is there inside the nucleus in other cells, like eukaryotic cells. Inside the nucleus, we come across chromosomes, and the chromosomes contain the genetic material in the form of DNA. So here, there is no well-defined nucleus. The genetic material, whatever that is supposed to be inside the nucleus, is basically naked. In the sense, nucleus is not surrounded by the membrane. Basically naked, not enveloped by a nuclear membrane. This is the most important feature of prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells, they do have genetic material. They do have genetic material, but surrounding this genetic material, as you see in case of eukaryotes, surrounding this genetic material which are present or which are contained in the chromosome, we do come across in the eukaryotes a distinct nuclear membrane. And such a nuclear membrane is not seen in prokaryotes. Therefore, we say prokaryotes possess the genetic material, and this genetic material is basically naked without the nuclear membrane. That is one of the most important features. You can see here, this is what a genetic material. And this genetic material, generally, it is called nucleoid. Nucleoid is nothing but DNA. You do not come across any color structures or chromosome-like structures here. Straight away you come across this nucleoid or DNA. And there is no nuclear membrane surrounding this DNA or nucleoid. And I said all prokaryotic cells have the cell wall. Yes, you have cell wall here. This is what you have, the cell wall. And inner to the cell wall, you come across the plasma membrane. What that is shown in green color here? That is the plasma membrane. Outer to the plasma membrane, you come across the cell wall. Right? So in this picture, you see something else outside the cell wall also. Yeah, you see something different. Let us study that. In addition to the genomic DNA, that is the single chromosome or with the circular DNA, a single chromosome, not like what you come across in eukaryotes, a number of chromosomes. The single chromosome or circular DNA. In addition to the genomic DNA, which is called a nucleoid, which is also called single chromosome or circular DNA, many bacteria have small circular DNA outside the genomic DNA. That is another important point. Outside the genomic DNA, this is the genomic DNA. Outside the genomic DNA, you do come across many more circular DNA, have small circular DNA outside the genomic DNA, and these smaller DNA are called plasmids. They are called plasmids. They are the plasmids. Very important part. Plasmids are also with the DNA. Plasmids, many bacteria have small circular DNA. And these circular DNA are present outside the genomic DNA, nucleoid, outside nucleoid. And these small DNA are called plasmids. Now, plasmid DNA confers certain unique phenotypic characters to such bacteria. So, these plasmids, which are present in the cytoplasm, they enable the bacteria to possess a certain phenotypic characters. One such character of the bacteria, because of these plasmids or because of this circular DNA, is resistance to antibiotics, one of the most important features. You are going to study about this more when you get into 12th standard. Remember? One of the most important features of the plasmids is that the plasmid DNA, it makes these bacteria to have one important phenotypic character, that is resistance to antibiotics. Or putting it in another way, if the bacteria possesses antibiotic resistance power, if the bacteria shows resistance to any antibiotics, it is because of the plasmids, and these plasmids, they contain circular DNA. You will be studying about plasmid DNA later, how they are helpful in the bacteria transformation, to monitor the bacteria transformation. Let us see that later in biotechnology chapter. Nuclear membrane is found in eukaryotes. Nuclear membrane is found in eukaryotes, and this nuclear membrane is not found in prokaryotes. Then that's all. Another important feature, no organelles like the ones in eukaryotes, whatever you see in eukaryotes, such organelles are not found in prokaryotic cells. No organelles like the ones in eukaryotes are found in prokaryotic cells except ribosomes. In eukaryotes, we are going to see them, we are going to study them later. In eukaryotes, you come across cell organelles like mitochondria, lysosomes, Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, etc., etc. What you see, the only cell organelle present in the prokaryotes. When compared to eukaryotes, is that of ribosomes. Except ribosome, ribosomes are present in both eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Except ribosome, there are no other cell organelles which are generally seen in eukaryotes, in the prokaryotes. Prokaryotes possess only one type of cell organelles, that is ribosomes. Other cell organelles which you see in eukaryotes are absent, are not found in prokaryotes. Prokaryotes have something unique in the form of inclusion. This is another important feature. Prokaryotes have something, or prokaryotes possess inclusions. What are these inclusions? A specialized differentiated form of cell membrane called mesosome is a characteristic of prokaryotes. I'll show that. There is a specialized cell membrane called mesosome. And this cell membrane is somewhat differentiated. A specialized differentiated form of cell membrane called mesosome is present in prokaryotes. And these mesosomes are nothing but infoldings of the cell membrane. They are the infoldings of cell membrane. That is why we say it is a specialized differentiated form of cell membrane. I hope you know cell membrane and plasma membrane, they are one and the same. Cell membrane is also known as a plasma membrane. And this cell membrane and plasma membrane, it gets pushed in and it forms a peculiar structure in the form of inclusion or infolding, and that is what is called mesosome. Let us see that. This is what I have already shown you. The innermost layer, innermost lining, which is in touch with the cytoplasm, is called plasma membrane or cell membrane. And this plasma membrane, cell membrane, it forms infoldings. It forms infoldings, and this infolding of the plasma membrane is known as mesosome. And as I already told you, this is a nucleoid material that is contained DNA, and these are all ribosomes. What you come across? Ribosomes. Right? Here you see the difference between the prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. If you want, you can have the screenshot of this. It is not there in your NCERT book. As well as, let us look into certain characteristics and compare these characteristics between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Nucleus. In prokaryotic cells, no. There is no nucleus. Eukaryotic cells, yes, they have nucleus. Membrane-bound organelles, no. In prokaryotes, eukaryotic cells, yes. Size of ribosome, 70S in prokaryotes, 80S in eukaryotes. Cell wall composition, peptidoglycans in prokaryotes, made up of peptidoglycan, no peptidoglycan. Mitotic division, no. Here, yes. DNA associated histones, no. Here, yes. Under eukaryotic cells. Number of chromosomes, one. Here, more than one. Cell membrane composition, no sterols. Here, sterols present. Number of cells, usually single, usually multicellular. Size of the cell, smaller within 1 to 5 μm. It is larger, 10 to 100 μm. These are the major differences between the prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cells. Always, you better to know that. And if at all you prepare a chart like this and just look into that, it enables you to memorize easily in the examination and you can write a beautiful answer. Now, let us look into a little bit more what you come across in prokaryotic cells. Cell envelope and its modifications. Most prokaryotic cells, particularly the bacterial cells, have a chemically complex cell envelope. You have already seen You already heard about plasma membrane. You already heard about outer tube plasma membrane in cell wall. Is that? That's all? No. Most prokaryotic cells, particularly the bacterial cells, have a chemically complex cell envelope. The cell envelope consists of a tightly bound three-layered structure. In prokaryotic cells, like a bacterial cells, the cell envelope consists of a tightly bound three-layered structure, that is, the outermost glycocalyx, followed by the cell wall, and then the plasma membrane. So, outermost layer is the glycocalyx. Inner to the glycocalyx is the cell wall. Inner to the cell wall is the plasma membrane or cell membrane. Or from inside outside, inside to outside, it is the plasma membrane, outer to plasma membrane, cell wall, outer to cell wall, you come across glycocalyx. You have already seen about this. You have already heard about that. This is the plasma membrane. And what you see, outer to the plasma membrane is the cell wall. Cell wall. Then you have the glycocalyx layer outside. Okay. Let us see that a little bit more here. So, although each layer of the envelope performs a distinct function, they act together as a single protective unit. The basic function of the cell envelope is the protection. So, here the cell envelope may contain the plasma membrane with its own distinct function, cell wall with its function, and glycocalyx layer outermost with its function. In total, all these layers of the envelope perform the single function, that is the protective function. The bacteria can be classified into two groups. On what basis? The bacteria are classified into two groups on the basis of differences in the cell envelopes. What have you heard about the cell envelope now? And the manner in which they respond to the staining procedure developed by Graham. That means, this scientist Graham, he has developed one stain. And some of the bacteria used to get stained by that chemical. And some other bacteria, they never used to get stained. So, based on the response of this bacteria to the stain developed by Graham, you have two types of bacteria, Gram-positive bacteria and Gram-negative bacteria. Let me tell you. There are some bacteria which take up this stain developed by Graham. There are some other bacteria which do not take up the stain developed by Graham. Therefore, bacteria are of two types, Gram-positive bacteria and Gram-negative bacteria. Let us read here. Bacteria can be classified into two groups on the basis of the differences in the cell envelopes and the manner in which they respond to the staining procedure developed by Graham. Those that take up the Graham stain are called Gram-positive, and the others that do not take up a Graham stain are called Gram-negative bacteria. Glycocalyx. You have already heard about glycocalyx. It is the outermost layer of the cell envelope. Glycocalyx differs in composition and thickness among different bacteria. Among different bacteria. Which one? Glycocalyx. Outermost layer in the cell envelope. This glycocalyx, which is invariably found in only prokaryotic cell, differs in composition and thickness among different bacteria. It could be, this glycocalyx could be a loose sheath called a slime layer in some, while in other bacteria, it may be thick and tough called a capsule. So, you have this glycocalyx in two forms. In some other bacteria, glycocalyx is a very loose sheath forming a slime layer. In some other bacteria, the glycocalyx forms very thick, tough layer, and this thick, tough layer is called capsule. You can see here, it is called capsule. Capsule. Thick, tough layer, capsule. Right? Look here. This is what you have. The glycocalyx layer. Right? Glycocalyx layer. And this is the glycocalyx. What it does? Glycocalyx. The glycocalyx aids in attachment of some cells to extracellular matrix components. Right? It binds antigens and enzymes to the cell surface. It facilitates cell-to-cell recognition and interaction. It protects cells from injury by preventing contact with inappropriate substances. It assists T cells and antigen-presenting cells in aligning with each other. Anyhow, these are not mentioned in NCR. What I wanted to show you is that there is a glycocalyx layer. And this glycocalyx layer is present outer to the cell wall, and inner to the cell wall, there is a plasma membrane. The cell wall, which is situated inner to the glycocalyx, the cell wall determines the shape of the cell and provides a strong structural support to prevent the bacterium from bursting open or collapsing. It is a function of the cell wall. The cell wall determines the shape of the cell and provides a strong structural support to prevent the bacterium from bursting or collapsing. The plasma membrane, which is present inside cell wall, is a semi-permeable in nature and it interacts with the outside world. As the name itself indicates, it is a semi-permeable membrane allowing certain substances to come in and certain substances to go out. This membrane is a similar structure to that of eukaryotes. So now I hope you have seen three layers in the cell envelope. Innermost is the plasma membrane. Next to the plasma membrane on the outer side is the cell wall. And outer the cell wall, the glycocalyx. And all these layers are with their own distinct functions. A special membrane structure is the mesosome. I already showed you the mesosome in our earlier slide. A special membranous structure, mesosome is a membranous structure as you can make out here, which is formed by the extension of the plasma membrane to the cell. Look here, this is the plasma membrane. Out of the plasma membrane, whatever that is shown here in the black color is the cell wall. And this plasma membrane, it forms some force towards the inside, And this force, whatever you come across, they are called mesosome. A special membrane structure is the mesosome, which is formed by the extension of the plasma membrane into the cell. This is the inner surface of the cell. Here you come across actually the cytoplasm. These extensions are in the form of vesicles or tubules, in the form of vesicles or tubules, or in the form of lamellae, plate-like structures. Right? This is the structure of the mesosome. The mesosomes always ask a question, very important. What is the role of mesosome? What is the significance of mesosome? The mesosome, it's nothing but the inward foldings of the plasma membrane. They help in cell wall formation, DNA replication, and distribution to daughter cells. See, in all these, they play a very important role. The mesosomes, whatever you have seen, they help in cell wall formation, DNA replication and distribution to daughter cells. They also help in the respiration, secretion processes to increase the surface area of the plasma membrane and enzymatic content. In all these, they play a very important role. Therefore, we can't ignore these mesosome. Even though they are simple protrusions of this plasma membrane, they play a very important role. They help in the cell wall formation, DNA replication, and distribution to daughter cells. They also help in the respiration, secretion, to increase the surface area of the plasma membrane and enzymatic content. So, these are the functions. Whenever you come across some more infoldings, you know that the surface area is increased. Surface area of the plasma membrane is increased. Right? In some prokaryotes, like cyanobacteria, there are other membrane structure. This is what cyanobacteria have. There are certain other membrane structure, membrane extensions into the cytoplasm, and these are called chromatophores. Chromatophores refers to colored bodies. chromatophores which contain pigment. Because of the pigment, they do show different colors. So, these are seen in cyanobacteria, prokaryotes like cyanobacteria, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria. There are other membrane extensions into the cytoplasm called chromatophores. So, you must know that chromatophores are nothing but the extensions of the plasma membrane into the cytoplasm. And they contain pigments, therefore they show different colors. Bacterial cells may be motile or non-motile. This is another important point. They may show movement or they may not show movement. Bacterial cells may be motile or non-motile. If they are motile, there must be some structure to help them to move. You know, motile means capable of moving. Non-motile means incapable of movement. Bacterial cells may be motile or non-motile. If motile, they have thin filamentous extensions. If motile, they have thin filamentous extensions from their cell wall. And these filamentous extensions arising from their cell wall are called flagella. So, if motile, they have thin filamentous extensions from their cell wall called flagella. And it is these flagella enables them to move. Bacteria show a range in the number and the arrangement of flagella. How many flagella should be there in a bacteria? It varies. It varies with the bacteria. It changes. It range. The bacteria show a range in the number and the arrangement of flagella. Look here. This is what you have. This is what you see. Flagellum. Flagellum is a singular. Flagellum plural. This is the flagellum. Right? Bacterial flagellum is composed of three parts. What are they? One is filament. Then, another one hook-like part. And one more that you come across is the basal body. Basal body. There are three components. Basal body, hook, and filament. Bacterial flagellum is composed of three parts. Filament, hook, and basal body. The filament is the longest portion and extends from the cell surface to the outside. This is the filament. It's the longest part and extends from the cell surface to the outside. Besides this long flagella, the bacteria also show another two structures. One is called pili. And another is called fimbriae. Besides flagella, pili and fimbriae are also surface structures of the bacteria, but do not play a role in motility. So, let me repeat again. You do come across in bacteria two types. One is motile and another is non-motile. Motile in the sense, capable of movement. Non-motile in the sense, incapable of movement. If they are capable of movement, they must have some structure which enables them to move. And this structure is called flagella. In a motile bacterium, we come across flagellum. And this flagellum shows the three structures, basal body, then hook, and filament. Filament. And the filament is the longest portion, which extends from cell surface to the outside. So, besides the flagellum, the bacteria also show, arising from their surface, also show two more structures called the pili and the fimbriae. The pili are elongated structures. Look here, these are all pili. The pili are elongated tubular structures made of a special protein. The fimbriae, which are shorter, small bristle-like structures. These are all fimbriae, small bristle-like fibers, which arise from the cell. The fimbriae are small bristle-like fibers. sprouting from the cell. In some bacteria, they are known to help attach the bacteria to rocks in the streams and also to the host tissues. Therefore, you must know there are two structures apart from flagellum. Flagellum is a structure which helps in the movement. There are two more structures which are not at all helpful in the movement. And these structures are called the pili, which are slightly elongated structures, tubular structures. And another one is the bristle structures called fimbriae. The pili and fimbriae, both these are not at all helpful in the movement. They are not at all concerned in the movement. And these are concerned in making this bacteria to attach or to adhere to rocks in the streams or to some of the host organisms or host tissues. Right? Now let us look into other structures that are present in ribosome. I have already told you that in case of bacteria, except ribosome, there are no other cell organelles in case of prokaryotes. In case of prokaryotes, like bacteria, in case of prokaryotes, except the ribosome cell organelle, no other cell organelles are present. So, in prokaryotes, ribosomes are found associated with the plasma membrane of the cell. Important point. In prokaryotes, ribosomes are associated with the plasma membrane of the cell. And these ribosomes are about 15 nanometer by 20 nanometer in size. Important point. These ribosomes found in the prokaryotes are about 15 nanometer by 20 nanometer in size and are made up of two subunits, 50 Swedberg and 30 Swedberg units. Very important point. First of all, the prokaryotic ribosomes are of 70S type. And these 70S prokaryotic ribosomes are made up of two subunits. One subunit is of 50S, and one subunit is called 50S, and another subunit is called 30S. Which when present together, these two subunits when present together, they form 70S prokaryotic ribosome. Very important point you have to remember. Ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis. Several ribosomes may attach to a single mRNA and form a chain called polyribosomes or polysome. Poly refers to many. Many of the ribosomes, they come and stand or get attached to the mRNA. When you see many ribosomes are found attached to the mRNA, then that particular chain is called polyribosome. Poly means many. It is a chain of many ribosomes, or simply it is called polysome. The ribosomes of a polysome, ribosomes that are present on the polysome, that are present in the form of polysome, the ribosomes of a polysome translate the mRNA into protein. You know, protein synthesis involves two processes. One is what is known as a transcription. Transcription is the formation of mRNA from DNA. And another process is that of the translation. That translation is the mRNA after getting formed inside the nucleus in general. Whenever this mRNA comes out, the mRNA makes this other type of RNAs, that are tRNA like that, to get this amino acid and to come and get attached to there. So this process where this mRNA helps to synthesize the protein is known as a translation. So the ribosomes of the polysome translate the mRNA into protein. We are going to study the details of this later. So what you have to remember is that you come across 70S type of ribosomes in the prokaryotes. And this 70S ribosome is made up of two subunits. One is what is called the 50S, and another is the 30S subunit. I'm going to show about something more about this point later. Now let us look into the another structure that is present in prokaryotic cell called inclusion bodies. Reserve material in prokaryotic cells are stored in the cytoplasm in the form of inclusion bodies. Inclusion bodies are some bodies present in the cytoplasm. They are called inclusion bodies. These are not bound by any membrane. Remember, these inclusion bodies are not bound by any membrane system and lie free in the cytoplasm. Which are these inclusion bodies? You have inclusion bodies like phosphate granule, cyanophysin granules, glycogen granules, etc. All these granules, whatever you come across, they simply lie in the cytoplasm and there is no any membrane covering them. So, inclusion bodies are without any membrane covering, lying freely in the cytoplasm, and examples for these inclusion bodies include phosphate granules, cyanophysin granules, and glycogen granules. And along with this, inside this prokaryotic cell, you may come across, especially in the blue-green algae, gas vacuoles. Gas vacuoles are found in the blue-green and purple and green photosynthetic bacteria. In these, blue-green and purple and green photosynthetic bacteria, we come across gas vacuoles also. So, these are all what you come across inside the that of the prokaryotic cells, right? So, with this knowledge on the prokaryotic cells, now let us take up the eukaryotic cell. Okay? You just recall what all you have studied with regard to prokaryotic cells, right? Summing up, we can see this. Prokaryotic cells, let us just go to that. Prokaryotic cells, I started here. Prokaryotic cells are exemplified by, or the most common examples for the prokaryotic cells include bacteria, blue-green algae. Blue-green algae are also as a cyanobacteria, mycoplasma, and pleuropneumonia-like organisms. These are the examples for prokaryotic cells. And prokaryotic cells are generally smaller in size than the eukaryotic cells. And the prokaryotic cells vary greatly in their shape and size. And the four basic shapes of bacteria, you know, bacteria are the most common prokaryotic cells. The four basic shapes of the bacteria include the rod-like bacteria, the comma-like bacteria, the spherical bacteria, and also the spiral bacteria. And the organization of the prokaryotic cell is fundamentally similar, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and function. And looking into what all the peculiar organization of prokaryotic cell, all prokaryotic cells have cell wall surrounding the cell membrane. And inside the cell membrane, you do come across cytoplasm. And what is the most important feature of the prokaryotic cell is that there is no well-defined nucleus. That means there is no nuclear membrane around the genetic material. Genetic material is basically naked without any nuclear membrane. And this is the naked genetic material, which is also called nucleoid. Nucleoid, and there is no nuclear membrane surrounding this. In addition to the genomic DNA present in the nucleus, you also come across very small circular DNA in many of the bacteria. And these circular DNA present outside the genomic DNA are called plasmid. And you know that plasmids have circular DNA. And possession of the plasmid is one of the most important features of that of the bacteria like the prokaryotes. And this plasmid DNA, it enables this bacteria to possess some unique phenotypic character, that is resistance to antibiotics. So, the nuclear membrane, even though it is found in eukaryotes, it is not found in the prokaryotes. So, in the prokaryotes, the plasmid DNA is used to monitor bacterial transformation with the foreign DNA. It is in genetic engineering. And whatever the cell organelles you come across in the eukaryotes, most of the cell organelles found in eukaryotes are not found in the prokaryotes except ribosome. Prokaryotes have something unique in the form of inclusion, and one of such inclusion is the mesosome. Mesosome is formed from the cell membrane and is a characteristic of prokaryotes. And mesosome is nothing but infoldings of the cell membrane. And this is the mesosome, and these are the differences between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. You have already noted these differences, and this you have to remember for board examination also. And with regard to the envelope, in case of prokaryotes, you do come across an envelope. And this cellular loop is formed over three layers. Outermost layer is the glycocalyx. The middle one is the cell wall, and the innermost is the plasma membrane or cell membrane. Although each layer of this cell envelope performs a distinct function, in total, the cell envelope is concerned with mainly protection. And you also know that bacteria are of two types based on whether they show response to the gram stain or not. There are some bacteria which take up this gram stain and are called gram positive, and there are some other bacteria which do not take up the stain, they are called gram negative. Now, with regard to the glycocalyx present on the outer side of the cell wall, it differs in composition and thickness amongst the different bacteria. So, if you look at the glycocalyx may be in the form of a loose sheath called a slime layer in some bacteria, while in others, it is a little bit tough and thick, and it's called capsule. The cell wall present in the prokaryotic cell, it determines the shape of the cell and provides a strong structural support to prevent the bacterium from bursting or collapsing. And the plasma membrane, which is present inside the cell wall, is a semi-permeable membrane allowing some of the materials to get in and some of the materials to go out. This membrane is a similar structurally to that of eukaryotes. And this is what you have heard about already, mesosome. A special membrane structure called mesosome is formed by the inward extension of the plasma membrane. And these extensions are in the form of vesicles or tubules or lamellae. So, the important function of the mesosome is they help in cell wall formation, DNA replication, and distribution to daughter cells. And mesosomes also help in respiration, secretion, and also the mesosome help by increasing the surface area of plasma membrane for the enzymatic action. In some prokaryotes, like cyanobacteria, there are other membrane extensions to cytoplasm. And these extensions are called chromatophores. And these chromatophores contain pigments, right? Bacterial cells may be motile or non-motile. As I said, in some of the bacteria, there is the flagellum, which enables them to move. And some other bacteria, there is no flagellum, which cannot move. If motile, they have thin filamentous extensions from their cell wall called flagella. Bacteria show a range in the number of arrangement of flagella. And in the flagella, you come across three parts. One is what is known as the basal body, the another is the hook part, and one more is the very long part known as filament. The filament extends from the cell surface to the outside. Besides this flagellum, the bacteria also shows the tumor structure. One is called the pili, and another is called fimbriae. The pili and fimbriae, they do not help in motility. They do not play any role in motility. And these are the pili, which are little bit tubular structures, elongated structures, right? And they are made up of proteins. And these short structures are called bristles-like structures, are called fimbriae. And in some bacteria, these help fimbriae and these pili help to anchor or help to adhere to some of these objects like rocks in the streams or to the tissues of the host body or host tissues. And you do come across, in case of these prokaryotes, ribosome of 70S type. Yes, refers to Swedenborg unit. And this 70S ribosome is made up of two parts, or two units. One is called 50S and another is called 30S. And you know, the ribosomes of the prokaryotes are 15 nm by 20 nm in size. Very important point to remember. And this 70S ribosome is formed of two subunits called 50S and 30S. Whenever they are present together, they form 70S. Ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis, and many ribosomes are found attached to the mRNA, and they form what is called a chain of polyribosome or polysome. The ribosomes of a polysome translate the mRNA, or the ribosomes of the polysome help in the synthesis of a protein by the process called translation. And as I have already mentioned, there are some inclusions inside the cytoplasm, and these inclusions are nothing but a reserve material. The reserve material in prokaryote cells are stored in the form of inclusion bodies, and these inclusion bodies are not covered by any membrane. And the most important inclusion bodies that are found in the prokaryote cells include phosphate granules, cyanophysin granules, and glycogen granules. And besides these granules, we also come across gas vacuoles in blue-green and purple and green photosynthetic bacteria. So that ends the study of this prokaryotic cell, and we are going to take up eukaryotic cell in our next class.
Welcome to Sushruta app. In this video we are going to demo NEAT topics and its related resources from slides and videos. Kindly give all the necessary permission and proceed to the main screen. Let us select Biology 11th as our subject. This will open up the syllabus for this subject. All the syllabus data regarding the subject will be loaded at this stage. Once the process is complete, the icon will be active. Zoom a bit so that the topics are clearly visible and click on the orange highlighter button. This will open up a selection box. Adjust the box so that it covers the topic you are interested in. Once this is done, confirm your selection by clicking on the green button. This will download the slides resources for that unit. Once the download is complete, it will ask you for the permission to download the textbooks from the NCERT site. Once the download is complete, it will open up the chapter and the subchapter hierarchy for the unit. Select one of the subchapter. In this case, I am selecting the first subchapter. It will load all the resources pertaining to that topic. Let us click the second icon, that is textbook. You will be given an option if there are many resources. Now you can see, it has directly taken us to the page of the selected topic. Click on the small green button to load all the icons back. Similarly, let us select the third icon, that is slides. It will open up the slides for the said topic. Finally, let us select the third icon, that is YouTube videos. This will show the videos related to the topic from IITPAL. If there are more than one video, select any one of the links and watch the video. Similarly, let us select another topic and follow the same procedure. Remember, downloading of slides is a one-time process per unit. Slides are being downloaded here, as we have visited this unit for the first time. The next time we visit the same unit, slides will be retrieved locally. We can also select a topic from slides and get its equivalent matching resource. In this case, I am selecting the topic, taxonomic categories, and getting its equivalent topic from the textbook. So here we have the textbook resource showing taxonomic categories. When there are too many topics selected, or the topic name match is not found, the list of entire topics will be shown to the student. He can select any one topic and proceed further. Let's click on the Moodle icon, seen on the syllabus screen. This will take you to the Moodle calendar, where you will be able to view all the scheduled events. Let us click on one of the events. There is an event for Biology Unit 1. On clicking it, we'll give a live lecture Google Meet link in it. Clicking on the link will directly open up Google Meet app where the lecture will be taken. Let us select a topic from the biology syllabus and proceed further. Now let us click the first icon, that is Gyan Chat. Gyan Chat is a medium where the students can interact with the other students via channels. Each subject unit will be having its own dedicated channel. Students can share their doubts or thoughts via this channel. Gyan Moodle would directly take you to the course material for that particular unit. These course materials will be uploaded on Moodle by the lectures. Now let us try out a different subject, that is physics. Let us click the textbook icon, and select the second option. This will open up a message box, displaying the page number, of the Kindle version of HC Verma book. On clicking OK it will open up the Kindle app with the book loaded. Once the book is loaded, click on the hamburger icon on the top, and select the Go To option. This opens up a dialog box, asking you to enter the page number. Enter the same page number, which was shown to you earlier, and click OK. This will directly take you to the page related to the topic you selected. Now let us see the formula sheet for physics. Formula sheet is provided to get a quick reference of all the formulas covered in the syllabus. If you want to refer to a topic from the formula sheet, simply select the topic and proceed further. We are also providing a link to the CEngage app. On clicking the CEngage icon, it will open the CEngage app. You will find all the test material inside My Bookshelf option. Finally, you can take the mock tests using the National Test Appeals app. Clicking on the icon will take you directly to the National Test Appeals app, where you can try out mock tests. Whenever a QR code is found inside the textbook, the student can select the QR code and he will be provided with e-content material. In this particular case, we have contents related to text PDF. In some cases, there will be video content, graphic and interactive content. Let us see how video content would look like from a different chapter.
Hello, my dear students. Very glad to meet you all. I am Professor G.K. Bhatt. In 2018 or during 2018 to 2020, I got an opportunity to visit nearly 25 institutions. And I used to teach in all these institutions biology, preparing the students for NEET exam. For NEET exam, you must be thorough with each and every word given in the NCERT book. That means biology, you have to buy out the NCERT book. Not simply by heading, understanding the concept and by heading. That is what is expected. Now let us start with this particular chapter, that is Animal Kingdom. And we shall look into the various components that are given here in the Animal Kingdom chapter. Under basis of classification. What characters, what points we are looking to classify the animals. That is what we are studying under basis of classification. In spite of differences in structure and form of different animals, there are a lot of differences in the structure, in their form, gross morphology. There are certain fundamental features common to various individuals. There are certain features common to various individuals in relation to arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom, patterns of digestive system, circulatory system, or respiratory.
We also have live lectures by world-class and dedicated tutors.
Well, that's all for this demo. Thanks for watching.